Ladies and gentlemen, Berta Worry here. I hope you guys had a fantastic weekend. Well, if you can look at my topic today, I have six things successful people do before 8 a.m. in the morning. And right now, it's kind of dark. I'm parked under a building. My husband has some business to do today, so I'm out here. So, okay, so let's go get started. So if you think about it, what do you care to do early in the morning? What do you normally do? What is your morning routine? So this was taken from Terry. She was talking about things that successful people do. So number one would be prayer. Imagine that, prayer. So I don't know about you, if you put on, you know, your worship music, whether you're reading your Bible, or, you know, what are you doing in the morning? So you should do that for 5 to 10 minutes, okay? Then number two is listening to a faith music. Listen to a faith reading or guidance, whether you're listening to someone on YouTube, you know, someone that's going to enrich your day, okay? So listen to that. And, you know, sometimes we need maybe to deal with some of the issues with unforgiveness. So number three is read. Leaders read. So it also talks about, you know, you need to read at least one book a month, right? So you can get the nuggets out of the book and then you'll be able to share it with your family and also with your team members. So you do that for about 10 to 20 minutes. Then number four, you review your dreams and goals. You know, you want to make it clear. So for instance, if you are going to clean the kitchen, you know, you put that on the list. If you're going to clean the closet, put that on there. Maybe wash the clothes, you know, it might be a mom, you know, a stay-at-home mom, working mom. So whatever it is for you, put it on paper. Then number five is exercise. Exercise. Take the time to exercise. And it says physical health is directly related to your emotional health. So make sure that you take time out, whether you're walking or jogging. Make sure that you are, you know, find the time to do that. And she was saying that for her, it was best to do that in the morning, because sometimes you find yourself as mom, we find ourselves probably not having enough time, you know, in at the ending of the day, right? You kind of, things probably, I don't know, like myself, sometimes I think I have more time than I do. And you find yourself at the end of the day, you're running out of time, right? You're running out of time. You don't want to do that. And then for me, I add number six. Number six would be breakfast. Breakfast is one of the most important meal of the day, because what does it mean is you're breaking the fast. Remember, you've been fasting, your body's been on a fast for the night, right? So that is breaking the fast. So make sure that you have a healthy breakfast, healthy, you know, not coffee and donuts and all that. There's no nutrition value in that. So make sure you have some, maybe some apples, oranges, make a smoothie, have some of those oatmeal, you know. Or sometime you might find yourself having your dinner for breakfast. Dinner for breakfast, right? So like I said, you're supposed to be eating like a queen or king in the morning, right? And then as you go out throughout your day, lunch is supposed to be eat very light for lunch. And then, you know, some most of the time you find yourself, you don't really need that third meal, okay? So you might want to go ahead and fast. And if you might be someone and say, hey, I can't stop my last meal, right? So maybe you might want to just have it light. Because what do you do after you have that last meal? Most of the time you find yourself, you go to bed. I mean, is that good? That's not good for you. That's not good for you. It's not very healthy. So those would be my six steps to for a successful person, okay? And then if you think about it, I have here, let me get my scripture correctly. I've got Matthew 6:33, okay? Let me go there and see what it says. So, but seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. So when you think about your the success tips, make sure that you don't stop comparing yourself with other people, because maybe your goal in life is bigger than the other person. So because your goal is bigger, or your dreams is bigger for your family, it requires you to do more, okay? you have to do more, right? So stop comparing yourself, okay? And then also, if you have a project to do, so it's a top over, so you do the heaviest task first, okay? So whatever that is, the biggest task should be done first, and then do the smaller ones. I hope that makes sense. And so I have one of my favorite texts is taken from Second Chronicles chapter 1 verses 7 to 12. And let me get my Bible here. I love it. So we talk about here. So when I'm talking about success, being successful, you cannot be successful on, you know, if you don't have God in your life. God is the one that brings us success. So with this text, it talks about here, verses 7, and it says, in that night did God appear unto Solomon and said unto him, ask, and I will give it, and I will give thee. So what is it that you have asking God for? You see that red light there? Somebody's coming out. So what is it that you have asking God for? Okay, what is it that you're asking him for? And so Solomon, so on verses 10, I won't go through the whole thing, but it's a great reading. I read the whole story. So if you look at verses 10, it says, give me now wisdom and knowledge that I may go out and come in before the people. For who can judge this people that is so great? And then verses 11 said, and God said to Solomon, because this was in thy heart, and thou hast not asked for riches, for wealth, or honor, now the life of thine enemies, neither ye have asked long life, but have asked for wisdom and knowledge for thyself, that thou makest judge my people over whom I have made thee king. Isn't that cool? So then this is verses 12. I like this one. Verses 12 says, wisdom and knowledge is granted unto thee, and I will give thee riches and wealth and honor such as none of the king has had that has ever before thee, neither shall there any after thee have like thee. Isn't that awesome? So that's the promises God. So if we realize that God is the one that's going to give us success, right? Whatever the dreams or the visions you have for your life, right? Put God first. Put God first. Making him be the ruler of your life. And because Solomon did not ask for the wealth, the riches of this world, he was granted what God has called him to. He was granted it. So, ladies and gentlemen, you know, my brother, my sister, God is calling you for such a time as this. So, you know, I hope that you have enjoyed this video as much as I've enjoyed making it for you. And if you want to dive deeper and go a little bit deeper, visit birddellwarrior.com. Until next time, ladies and gentlemen, have a super awesome day. Talk to you guys soon. Bye-bye.